Before that, we'll present a very beautiful composition by one of the greatest musicians of all time. He's called Sangeeta Pitamaha, the great grandfather of Indian classical music, not only Carnatic, of Hindustani also, Sri Purandara Dasa. Purandara Dasa lived 600 years ago, and he was a very mercenary jeweler to start with, who, though he was very, very rich, he would not spend even 1 rupee. Actually, he could have been born now in the time of demonetization. Anyway, none of us can spend money now. but with the Indian rupee value from that time, 600 years ago, he made 9 crores. So we, in Indian system of measuring, we have 100, then one more zero is 1,000, then we have 10,000, and one more zero is 1 lakh, and 100 lakhs is 1 crore. And like that, he had 9 crores money 600 years ago, which some money-loving person has calculated with the current value and estimated that he must have had something like 300 times more money than Bill Gates, Purandara Dasa. So now, after we found the wealth in the Padmanabha Swami temple, we can see that maybe these stories are true also, because we never imagine. Then the story goes that he never gave any money to anybody, but his wife was a very generous lady, and whoever visited their house, she would give them money, food, drink, everything. And he would always forbid her from doing that. Then one day he came to know that whoever comes, she gives things. So once he locked up everything in the house, there was absolutely nothing to give. And he himself disguised himself like a beggar, and he came and asked, "Please, can you give something?" So his wife had absolutely nothing. So she gave her wedding ring to the beggar and sent him away. So he was so, so angry, as you can imagine. Then he came in the evening, and of course she didn't have a wedding ring. So he said, "Where is your ring?" So she said, "I have just kept it in the puja room, in the room where I worship God." Then he said, "You bring it." So the story goes that she went to the puja room and prayed to God, saying, "See, all these beggars, I feel they are your children only. That's why I am generous. And now my husband is going to be really angry. Please do something." And apparently, miraculously, a ring appeared on her finger. So his name was Srinivasan Aikar. At that, he was not yet become Purandara Dasa. So she came and showed the ring, and he was really zapped. He said, "Hey, how did you do that? So tell me the truth, because I only came as the beggar." Then she said, "I just prayed to God and I got the ring." Then just in that moment, his entire life changed. And he realized that there are some bigger things than money. And he decided to leave his entire wealth, his house, his shop, his business, everything, and just go to this place in North India called Pandharpur, where there is a very famous temple which is there even now, Lord Vishnu in the form of Lord Vithala. Then he went there, started composing songs. Till then he had no music, nothing. But automatically, as a source of divine inspiration, he started composing thousands and thousands and thousands of songs. And in Hindustani music, one of the biggest names is Mia Tansen. He's made so many ragas, Miyan Ki Malhar, Miyan Ki Todi. So all this Tansen. Tansen's guru was a gentleman called Swami Haridas. And Haridas's guru is Purandara Dasa. So that, he's like right at the pinnacle. There's no Indian music without Purandara Dasa. But he has made very simple songs, small geetams, and those of us in Trivandrum or Karnataka or Madras or London, anywhere, if we learn Carnatic music, we have these basic exercises, sari, 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 gama, sari. All those were set 600 years ago by Purandara Dasa, and they are so perfect that nobody has felt like changing them. Even now we sing Lambodara Lakumikara. All those songs Purandara Dasa made. So we'll present it was very difficult to select a Purandara Dasa song, because each of them is like a diamond. And one story is that when he was a jeweler and he was a multimillionaire, he used to go to the Maharaja, the ruler's palace, with his latest creation of a diamond ring and present it before the king and stand like this. Once he left everything and he went to Pandharpur and he became a saint and he became very, very famous. He started attracting a lot of devotees. And then the Maharaja heard that there's this great saint in Pandharpur, and the Maharaja came and stood like that before him. So then he said, when I was a millionaire, I was standing like this in front of you, and now I have nothing and you are standing in front of me. So that is the irony of life. So this Tyagaraja Swami, they all followed the this policy where they would go begging on the street, and if they didn't get anything, they would starve. So they would eat only what people gave with a kind heart. So like we have rice, there's another edible thing called ragi. So this whole composition is when he's going begging for ragi. Ragi tandira bhikshake ragi tandira. If you know Malayalam, it's kind of easily understandable. Bhiksha ayata ragi taru tandira. Then he makes a word play with the word ragi. Yogya ragi. In Malayalam we say yogyan ai. Ai in Kannada is agi. So every word yogyan ai, bhogyan ai, bhagyavantan ai becomes yogya ragi, bhogya ragi, bhagyavanta ragi, ragi tandiriya. So ragi, 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 it will keep coming. This is a Purandara Dasa song. Ragi tandira ragi tandira bhikshake ragi tandira ragi tandira bhikshake ragi tandira bhikshake ragi tandira ragi tandira bhikshake ragi tandira bhikshake ragi tandira yogya ragi bhogya ragi yogya ragi bhogya ragi bhagyavanta ragi neevu yogya ragi bhogya ragi bhagyavanta ragi neevu ragi tandira ಅನ್ನದಾನವ ಮಾಡುವರಾಗಿ ಅನ್ನ ಛತ್ರವ ನಿಟ್ಟವರಾಗಿ ಅನ್ನದಾನವ ಮಾಡುವರಾಗಿ ಅನ್ನ ಛತ್ರವ ನಿಟ್ಟವರಾಗಿ ಅನ್ಯವಾರ್ತೆಯ ಬಿಟ್ಟವರಾಗಿ ಅನುದಿನ ಭಜನೆಯ ಮಾಡುವರಾಗಿ ಅನ್ಯವಾರ್ತೆಯ ಬಿಟ್ಟವರಾಗಿ ಅನುದಿನ ಭಜನೆಯ ಮಾಡುವರಾಗಿ ಪಾಪ ಕಾರ್ಯವ ಬಿಟ್ಟವರಾಗಿ ಮಾತಾ ಪಿತೃಗಳ ಸೇವಿಪರಾಗಿ ಪಾಪ ಕಾರ್ಯವ ಬಿಟ್ಟವರಾಗಿ ಜಾತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಮಿಗಿಲಾದವರಾಗಿ ನೀತಿ ಮಾರ್ಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಖ್ಯಾತರಾಗಿ ರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ ಭಿಕ್ಷಕರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ ಭಿಕ್ಷಕರ ಪಡೆದವರಾಗಿ ಗುರುವಿನ ಮರ್ಮವ ತಿಳಿದವರಾಗಿ ಗುರು ಕಾರುಣ್ಯವ ಪಡೆದವರಾಗಿ ಗುರುವಿನ ಮರ್ಮವ ತಿಳಿದವರಾಗಿ ಗುರುವಿನ ಪಾದವ ಸ್ಮರಿಸುವರಾಗಿ ಪರಮ ಪುಣ್ಯವ ಮಾಡುವರಾಗಿ ರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ ಭಿಕ್ಷಕರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ ಭಿಕ್ಷಕರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ ಸಿರಿರಮಣನ ಸದ ಸ್ಮರಿಸುವರಾಗಿ ಗುರು
ಕಾಡಿಗೆ ಬಾಹೋರಾಗಿ ವೀರ ಮನನ ಸದ ಸ್ಮರಿಸುವರಾಗಿ ಗುರುಗಿಗೆ ಬಾಹೋರಂಗವರ ಕರೆ ಕರ ಸಂಸಾರ ನೀಗುವರ ಕರೆ ಕರ ಸಂಸಾರ ನೀಗುವರ ಪುರಂದರ ವಿಠಲನ ಸೇವಿತರಾಗಿ ಪುರಂದರ ವಿಠಲನ ಸೇವಿತರಾಗಿ ಪುರಂದರ ವಿಠಲನ ಸೇವಿತರಾಗಿ ರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ ಭಿಕ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ ಭಿಕ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ ರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ ರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ ಭಿಕ್ಷಕ್ಕೆ ರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ ಭಿಕ್ಷಕರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ ಭಿಕ್ಷಕರಾಗಿ ತಂದಿರ.